Hello everyone, I am Rajesh from Asian Technology. We are learning complete PHP course from beginner to professional level. And last class we learned how to print hello world, right? And also we know if you write anything between double quote, that means that is a string, right? And if you don't use double quote, that means that is integer, correct? And today we are going to learn how to create variable and how to use variable. So let's start. So I'm going to write here variable. So for variable, let me tell you something, what you can do and how you can create and how you cannot create. Means something is allowed to create and something is not allowed. So let me tell you, you can't start with number. You cannot start with any number like 1, 2, 3, 4. Always you have to start with alphabet like A, B, C, D is fine, but you cannot start with number. Also you cannot start with this sign, understand, right? Cannot start with this sign. So this is the rule. And the second rule, you can start with alphabet means string, right? You can start with string means A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, any things. Also you can start with dash, this sign. Also you can start with capital letter or small letter, yeah, is allowed, but you cannot start with number and this sign. So let me create one variable first with this, using this rule. So let me create here. Simply I want to create a number, means number. I'm going to write it small, is equal to 100. And always when you create any variable, you have to write here semicolon. Don't forget semicolon. That means the number 100 is going to assign an in number, right? So that means the number is equal to 100, right? But in PHP, always when you want to create any variable, so this is variable now, any variable, you always have to write dollar sign. So this means the variable is num, but this is data type. This means only one have data type in PHP, just dollar sign. And this is integer, this is a data type. So why integer? Because you don't have point number, right? So if you don't have point number, have just a number, that means that is integer. So now here the number is equal to 100, right? So if you print number, that means you want to print 100, correct? Let me show you. Print, in PHP print is always echo, right? Echo, right? And they write num, is correct? Of course not, because you have to write dollar sign also here. So always you have to write dollar sign. Don't forget dollar sign, because variable always with dollar sign. And if you want to print this one, please don't forget here semicolon. So let me run this program. So before run this program, you have to start your local server, right? So let me search here, jump, you see here, and double click. Then you see here like this, right? Then start first and start second. If you don't want to start second, it's also fine, because the second one mysql, that means only dealing with database, and the first one dealing with PHP. You minimize this, and I'm going to run this program. So let me find the program in my file here, go in C drive, and then jump doc, see here the folder, and inside folder have a this index, you can find, see here, right? So you cannot run from here. Always you have to run from browser, because PHP is server side language. So you have to start your browser. So if you minimize this, this is my browser, right? So here I'm going to create a new tab, and I'm going to write here first localhost. After localhost, you cannot write index. You have to write this file, this folder name. Folder name is PHP, right? You already know this. Enter, you see 100. So if you minimize this file here, you see 100, right? So what about if I want to start with number? That means, what about if I start with number? So let me start with number. The same thing, I want to start with number, any number, 1, 2, let me 2. So let me print 2. So is allowed? Is not allowed, right? If you want to create variable, this is variable, you cannot start with number. Let me print again here. You see, syntax error, unexpected 2. Unexpected 2, where is 2? Line number 11. See, line number 11, right? Unexpected 2. So let me delete this 2, and also I have to delete from here, right? So refresh, you can see here, because 2 is not allowed, cannot start with number, right? Also you cannot start this sign using this sign. For example, let me show you here this sign. You see, it's going to make comment. So you cannot start. What about dollar sign? You cannot start with dollar anymore, because you see, here is not the proper, right? It's not correct way. But you can, I can show you here. You see here, the num is here, right? It's here. Why? Because undefined variable num. So you cannot start with this. Also, you cannot start with. Means you cannot start with this kind of symbol or using number, right? So always you have to start with very string, any number, like any alphabet, ABCD, anything. Understand, right? I hope you guys understand how to create variable, right? It's very easy. And here you no need to worry about integer and float, because you just write here number, automatic your PHP going to know this is integer or float. For example, I want to write here float, this some number, just like this. So also a point number. If I have point, this means this is not integer, this is float, right? Float. So float, you cannot change here anything, nothing here, just same. Let me print here, you see. So this here in PHP is very easy. You no need to worry this is alphabet or this is integer or float or long or double. You no need to worry, right? Just you have to write dollar sign. But in other languages like Java, JavaScript, and the other, you have to write, for example, this is now is integer, right? So you cannot write dollar there, you have to write there int, because this is integer. So now point, you have point, that means this is float, right? So you have to write float. If I have more here, so you have to write double. Understand, right? But here is very nice, you no need to write even float, double, anything. You just have to write dollar here. And PHP automatic know this is here. PHP going to see here, then PHP automatic know this is float or integer. I will teach you everything, float, integer, the data types, in few, in maybe next lecture. But today you I'm just going to teach you how to you can create a variable and how you can print the variable, how you start, how you cannot start, right? And also, what about if I want to print name? I just print number, right? I assign here just number. What about I want to print some name here? So it's same, nothing different. Just anything here. Let me simply here, I want to create variable name. And the name is my name. So it's correct? Of course not correct, because you know this is a string, right? So a string always inside double quote. You know, right? So I'm going to make double quote. You see, now here don't forget semicolon. So now if you see double quote, and inside double quote is anything that is only string, right? So here now string. So here not going to change anything, just change here double quote. So I'm going to print name. So what is going to print? Name is Rajesh, right? So that means going to print Rajesh. Refresh. You see here. Very interesting and very nice, right? So what about last name? I want to print one more here. Dollar sign, last, and the name, right? You cannot write like this. If you want to write like this, it's also fine. Yadav. Dollar here, semicolon. And I want to print this one, right? Copy, I'm going to paste here. If you write like this, you can print. There have no problem. Yadav. But this is not a perfect way, because you see, last and the name is a two word, right? So when you finish first word, when you're going to start the second one, you have to make something here. It maybe is fine. This one also fine. See here. Yeah. See, nothing different, right? Also, you can start camel case. Camel case means when you finish first word, you're going to write second one, first letter is capital. This is calling camel case. For example, my first word is finished, right? The second name is capital. Last name is again third one, right? You see here, first my, second, then first letter capital, and third the first letter capital. So this is called camel case, because small, capital, capital. So if I want to print this one, also same. See, yeah, that's same. So I hope you guys understand how to create variable, right? It's very easy how to create variable and how you can print the variable. And next video, we are going to learn something more in PHP. We will finish PHP, basic PHP very soon, maybe in 1 or 2 weeks, maybe in 2 weeks. The basic one. After basic, we will start project, and also we will learn op concept and the framework. But before framework, we will finish one project, then we will start framework. So see you in next class. Stay tuned. Goodbye.